President Marcos laughing off accusations from controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy. Marcos says there's no truth to Quiboloy's claims. His administration is conniving with the U.S. to assassinate him. He also urges Quiboloy to attend congressional hearings in order to air his side.
Walang may gusto mag-assassinate sa kanya. Bakit siya assassinate? Wala namang ano yun. Ha? What, I mean, you know, why will anyone want to do that?
The cases against him in the U.S. Were filed before I became president. So, I guess he's very worried. I would just advise him that kung meron naman siyang sasabihin, if he has an opportunity in the hearings, both in the House and in the Senate, to say his side of the story. Ngayon, kung sinasabi niya, hindi totoo lahat yan, hindi totoo, walang nangyaring ganyan, di sabihin niya.
Both the Senate and the House have issued subpoenas for Quiboloy after he skipped separate hearings into his alleged abuses and franchise issues hounding SM&I. The Philippine Justice Department vows to review a Navotas court ruling in the murder of teenager Jemboy Baltasar. The court on Tuesday found only one policeman guilty of homicide, while four other policemen were given lesser charges. Baltasar's family and their lawyers see lapses in the investigations, calling the conviction not enough.
Pwede pa din natin i-argue on appeal. Isa na po dyan yung conspiracy, yung isa din yung intent to kill, the reasonableness of the action taken by the police and the reaction that was that the police had nung medyo patakas si Jemboy.
Meanwhile, the Philippine National Police says Baltasar's case should serve as a lesson to all policemen. The PNP also vows to ensure protection of the victim's family amid concerns of possible retaliation.
Kung kailangan po ng servisyo ng PNP, kailangan po silang proteksyonan at bigyan ng security. Ang pakiusap lang natin sa kanila ay pagtiwalaan ang PNP, bagamat may mga nasangkot na pulis. Pero sa pangkalahatan, naniniwala po tayo na marami pa rin po ng pulis na dapat pagtiwalaan po.
Senator Rizzo Antiveros questions the lighter sentence given to police officers involved in the killing of Jemboy Baltasar. For Antiveros, there is no moving on from the case since justice was not truly served. She also thanks the Justice Department for ordering a review of the court ruling.
Kahit pakiramdam natin ay nabigo tayo kahapon, hindi tayo magmamasid lang. Tuloy ang laban para sa malawakang pagbabago sa loob ng ating mga institusyon, kung saan ang hustisya ay hindi lang para sa mga mayayaman at may kapangyarihan. Nirerespeto naman natin ang hatol ng korte sa kasong murder laban sa mga pulis na botas. Pero yung 5 sa 6 na pulis, lalaya, uuwi na. Ang pamilya Baltasar, habang buhay magluluksa. Nasang banda dyan ang pananagutan.
The Baltasar family also vowing to continue the fight for justice.
Iganin lang po ba yung buhay ng anak ko? Na parang hindi tao yung napatay nila. Sila makakalaya. Apat na taon lang makukulong. Pero yung anak ko, habang buhay na hindi na makakabalik, hindi na makakapag-aral. Saka may pangarap po sana yung anak ko na maging seaman. Ayun po yung inaano sa pagkakamali lang nila. Sana po makuha namin yung hustisya at lalaban po kami para sa pamilya po namin. Yun lang po.
More Philippine provinces affected by the El Nino phenomenon. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the number has risen to 51. That's up from the 41 affected provinces as announced by the government's El Nino Task Group some 2 weeks ago. Latest data showed 24 provinces facing drought, 17 experiencing a dry spell, and 10 under dry conditions. The Philippine Disaster Management Agency says estimates agricultural damage from El Nino to have already exceeded 800 million pesos. Meanwhile, agricultural officials delivered aid to the drought-stricken town of Bulalacao in Oriental Mindoro. The town earlier declared a state of calamity.
Para doon sa mga immediate na naapektuhan ng El Nino ay mamamahagi tayo ng up to 21,000 pesos na insurance claims mula sa Philippine Crop Insurance Corporations. Ganun din ay naglaan ng 500 million pesos ang Agricultural Credit Policy Council para sa credit assistance, about 25,000 pesos sa bawat magsasaka.
The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources identifies 7 areas positive for toxic red tide in its latest bulletin. Among them, 2 areas in eastern Visayas. Let's get our details now from our correspondent Sharon Evita. Sharon, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina. Eastern Visayas Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources warned against consumption of shellfish from specific locations due to concerns over toxic red tide. Due to the ongoing issues with paralytical shellfish poison contamination. According to DFAR, shellfish samples from San Pedro Bay in Basay Samar and Batarungao Bay in Eastern Samar, including General MacArthur, Kinapundan, Hernani, and Salcedo, have tested positive for paralytical shellfish poison contamination beyond the acceptable regulatory limit. DFAR warned that all types of shellfish and alamang harvested from these areas are deemed unsafe for human consumption. Seawater samples collected from the coastal waters of Biliran Island also continue to show the presence of Pyridinium bahamense, a toxic microorganism responsible for the causing of paralytic shellfish poison. As a result, a local red tide warning remains in effect for the bay, urging the residents to refrain from gathering, selling, and consuming shellfish and alamang from the area. While the advisory underscores the risk associated with shellfish consumption, it assures the public that fish, squids, shrimps, and crabs from the affected bays and coastal waters are safe for consumption, provided they are fresh, thoroughly washed, and have had their internal organs, such as gills and intestines, removed before cooking. Sharon Evita, EBS, CBN News.
The Commission on Higher Education eyes collaboration with universities in Turkey. CHED Chairman Prospero de Vero made that statement during the 9th Annual Eurasia Higher Education Summit 2024 in the European country. The Philippines eyes to ink collaboration deals with Turkey aimed at improving learning in agriculture, medicine, science, and technology. De Vera says they also aim to strengthen Manila's bilateral ties with Ankara to promote the internationalization of higher education institutions. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez bears government's plan to increase monthly grocery discounts enjoyed by senior citizens and persons with disabilities by nearly 100%. Romualdez says he met with trade officials Tuesday, and they are amenable to his request to raise the discounts to 500 pesos for the vulnerable sector before the end of March. The speaker adds this move aligns with the Marcos administration's goal of promoting inclusivity and social justice. The DTI, however, notes the discounts only cover basic goods and typical items consumed daily, such as rice, meat, vegetables, among others.